Hello. In this video, we'll be looking at how we can create a product feed and upload it into Google Merchant Center. First off, we need to make sure that our plugin is installed. So you can go to Plugin, Add New, and you can search up CTX Feed. This is the plugin that you need to install. As you can see, we have more than 30,000 active installations. At this point, in my WordPress site, I already have it installed. So I'm just going to jump straight into that. To create a new feed, click on the plugin and click on Make Feed. This will take you to this new screen where you need to choose the country that you'll be making this feed for. In this case, I'll choose the United States. Since we're uploading this feed into Google Merchant Center, the template you want to choose is Google Shopping. You can name the file whatever you want. In this case, I'll just name it My Feed 1. Let's keep the feed type at XML. Now you can choose the kind of variations you want to include in your feed. Let's keep the language at English and the currency at US dollars. Now you can choose the item wrapper and the single item wrapper that you're going to see when your XML feed is going to be created. As you can see, this is what the feed config looks like. Now, since we've chosen Google Shopping as our template, our team has already pre-populated with most of the Google attributes needed to create a feed for Google Merchant Center. These are all the attributes available under the feed config. Let's look at one of these, Google Product Category. Now, in this case, we'll be choosing Pattern, which gives us a static value. We're assuming that all the products that we'll be uploading from our feed will fall under one category. In this case, we're using clothing as an example. As you can see, the plugin automatically pre-populates with all the different categories available within Google. If you want to learn more about Google categories, you can actually just Google and find the list of all the Google product categories available by Google. Now let's look at a few other attributes. As you can see, you've got attributes like regular prices and sale prices, and both of them we are suffixed by US dollars. Now for manufacturer, we've got the attribute where we have set it up in such a way that it dynamically picks up the correct brand for the product that we have put in our feed. However, if we wanted, you can also put this as a static value. In this case, I have put a static value of my brand. So everything that's going to be exported, all the products will be named my brand. Now let's update and produce this feed. As you can see, the feed is actually created quite fast, and this is my feed right here called My Feed 1. And this is the feed URL. And if you want, you can copy this URL because you'll be needing this later on. Let's jump into Google Merchant Center right now. As you can see, under all products, we don't have anything here right now. We'll be using feed that we have created in our website to upload all the products here to Google Merchant Center. So let's get started. Under the country of sale, we're going to choose United States to keep it consistent as our feed. Let's choose the language as English, and under destination, for now, we'll just be focusing on the free listings. Let's continue. Now you have to name your feed. You can name this whatever you want, but for consistency purposes, we're going to name this My Feed 1, which is the same as our feed in our website. You can use Google Sheets to upload your data, or you can have scheduled fetches to get the data from your website. You can actually upload it using SFTP or FTP servers, or you can also use a content API. In this case, in this example, we'll be using scheduled fetches from the website. Now let's continue. Once again, let's rename this file My Feed 1. Let's put whatever time we want at whatever time zone we'd require. Now this is the important bit. You want this file URL to be fetching the data from your website. This is the URL you're looking at, the feed URL. So you're going to copy that and then you're going to paste it right here. If you want, you can add a username and password if your data is sensitive and you want to protect it, but for now, I'll just keep it empty. Let's create this feed. Right now, we can see that my feed has been already processed. Now, sometimes your feed will not process for scheduled uploads unless that time of the day has arrived. So you can always force the upload by clicking on Fetch Now. Right now, as you can see, your file is being processed, and the amount of time that it will take depends on the size of the feed that you have created. So we'll wait until this feed is being processed. After the feed has been processed, we can see that there are some issues with our data. Some of our data does not meet the product data specification specified by Google. Now, if you scroll down, if you want, we can actually go ahead and download the error report. But here on the UI, we can also scroll down and look at where the issues are. Here we have some URL where the attribute links are not valid. In one of the attributes down here, we can see that we are missing description, which we can easily fix later on. And in one of the products, we have price that is missing. So let's dig deeper into it. Let's focus at this particular error message. As you can see, the item ID 295 is missing a price. So right now, and it's in line 8. So right now what we're going to do is we're going to export our feed and we're going to look at it. Now if we narrow down item 295, we can easily find out what the item is. At this point, you can see that this is ladies' shoes. So let's jump into our products and find out where this item is. As you can see, it's right on top, and correctly, it is missing its price. So let's go to quick edit and give it a price. Let's say the regular price is $50 and the sale price goes down to $40. Let's update it. As you can see, the website picks up taxes as well, which is perfectly fine. Now what we have to do is we have to reprocess our feed. So let's go into my feed one, scroll all the way down and update and generate feed. After this feed is successfully generated, what we want to do is go back into Google Merchant Center and fetch the file once again. Now we have successfully reprocessed the file. Let's look at our error messages. Right now we can see that error message with the price has completely disappeared because we have already fixed that issue. Let's look at another error message. We can see that item 294 and 41 are missing descriptions. Let's look more into it. Let's look up item 294, search that up. And we can easily see that item 294 is basically the perfume, the bottled perfume. Let's find out item 41. Let's search up 41, and under 41, if we look further into it, okay, it is the belt. So right now what we'll do is we're going to go back into products and look at these descriptions. Well, we have identified that the bottle perfume is missing description. Let's look more into it. As you can see correctly, the bottle perfume is actually missing its description. So we're going to fill this in with some text. This is a great perfume. Sorry, this is a terrible description, but we're just going to fill this up to avoid the error message. We'll update it. And the next item we had is belt, which was also missing its description. Now let's fill this up with text as well. Very strong belt. Now let's update it. After making changes to our products, we need to go back to our feed file and regenerate it. So let's just do that now. It's going to take a few seconds. Perfect. Now that we have a new feed file, we can go back to Google Merchant Center and fetch the data once again. After fetching the data is complete, we can see that the issue with the missing description is no longer there. We have already fixed the issue. Ideally speaking, you want to make sure all the error messages are dealt with before you actually upload in Google Merchant Center. You can always go back to your feed and you can regenerate it by clicking this button. You can also make changes to your website if needed be. But always go ahead and make sure to go back to feeds and re-upload it after changes are made. Even after our errors, under all products, you can see that all of our products have successfully been uploaded. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. This is how you can take your feed and upload into Google Merchant Center. Please like the video and subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you very much. Thank you.